the worst flu for men sure is a man flu. Bro, if you guys don't know what the man flu is, oh my god, I've had man flu before. Jesus. If you've actually never had man flu, hopefully you guys can see this and you'll understand what's going on. For women, they think it's a joke. They think it's absolutely crazy. I think one of the worst diseases to strike humankind is the man flu. It's definitely serious. So guys, I understand what you're going through. I've had man flu before. It's absolutely ridiculous. Women think that it's a joke. A lot of people think it isn't serious. Man flu is absolutely ridiculous. If you guys have never seen what the man flu can do to somebody, I think we should take this time to understand virology and what it can do to you.
Wake up! Quick, there's a man!
What is it, nurse?
He has the flu.
My god. Not the man flu.
That's right.
What's the status?
Jono, male in his 30s, girlfriend called 111 this morning when he woke up complaining of a sore throat and wouldn't stop talking about it.
How long's he been sick?
Only since this morning, but he's been acting like it's been an entire week. He could barely get off the couch when we arrived.
Jono, I'm Dr. Boyce. How are you feeling?
Terrible. I've got a runny nose.
Temperature?
Barely elevated, but he keeps asking for a cold flannel.
Sweating.
Guys, I just want to tell you right now, if one of your boys gets the man flu, make sure you take care of him. Ladies, if your husband, your boyfriend, ever gets the man flu, please make sure he's okay. The man flu is probably one of the worst pandemics to ever hit, you know, the face of the earth. A lot of people don't talk about it. They don't shed any light on it. The man flu is absolutely a very serious thing. And men can actually attract the man flu. So if they get it, please be cautious with them. Understand that things are going on. It's 100% real. You know, if something's going on, man flu can cause serious symptoms. And this video shed some light on the man flu. I want to give you guys a chance to educate yourselves and see what the man flu can actually do to you.
I got a fever. I want a hot chockey, a bath, and a fluffy pillow.
Okay, team. This is Jono. Male, suspected man flu.
I don't understand. I had a cold last week and I still went to work. What is wrong with her?
Someone needs to calm her down. Chest is clear.
I've got a cough.
I don't know how to tell you this. She had man flu.
Oh, God.
Oh, my God, dude. Jesus. If one of your boys gets diagnosed with man flu, please, guys, please. Take care of him. Look out for him. Just check on him. Bro, if the man flu strikes, your chances of survival are absolutely ridiculous. Guys, if one of your boys gets the man flu, you're uneducated. Dude, if one of your boys gets the man flu, if you get the man flu, just shoot me a Discord message. I'll do everything I can. I'll do everything I can for you. Man flu is a serious thing. You guys got to understand, bro. The man flu is detrimental to us men, to us gamers. To all of us, dude. If your boys get the man flu, I'm trying to educate people. They think it's a joke. Women don't understand it. Man flu is absolutely detrimental to us.
Cody just had a cold.
He does just have a cold. That's great.
I got so much life to live.
We are doing everything we can, okay?
You gotta get my will.
I'm gonna die. Not on our watch.
Obviously not. He's barely even ill.
Watch it, Dr. Crossman. You do not want to cross the line.
Double pull the life support. End it.
He's not even on life support. You just have a harmless cold. Physically, you're barely even sick. Behaviorally, you're a bit of a nightmare.
He wanted a cold flannel.
Wow.
Mummy! Mummy!
Jono, honey. Oh, God, I came.
The audacity of this doctor, the fact that she could even sit here and tell this man he's barely even sick, like he absolutely has the man flu. The fact that she can sit there and tell this guy, you're not even sick, she should be fired. She's woman-splaining? Boys, she's literally belittling man flu. The man flu is absolutely detrimental to us, dudes. Cancel.
As soon as I heard,
I'm gonna die.
I'll make sure that you get everything that you need.
Did you remember that game? Blinky is right here.
Oh. Hi, so sorry to interrupt. I was just wondering, would someone mind looking at this?
Oh, someone get her out of here. We are dealing with an emergency.
I've just been shot in the arm.
Oh my god. She comes in saying she's been shot, and he's literally got diagnosed with man flu. I can't stand you. Oh my god, the wife is here. She's one of the people that I want to bring awareness to, guys. My wife doesn't understand how detrimental man flu can be. I think it's a disease that seriously affects us, guys. You know, we're here to bring education to women, to bring education to the mainstream. Man flu trying to put the grind on halt? Yeah, absolutely, guys. I'm so sorry you haven't learned about this. Guys, my wife just hopped in chat. She obviously said she can't stand me. Babe, we're trying to educate mainstream media. I don't believe enough light has been shed on the man flu. It's detrimental. I feel targeted at times. I feel like there's not enough education. There's not enough awareness. And they don't do enough for us. And it's absolutely disgusting. This doctor right here told him that he's not even sick. This woman ran in with a gunshot wound in the arm. I don't understand. I don't know. I've been trying to educate her for years. Guys, please cut her some slack. You know, she's never actually had to deal with man flu around her. So she's not entirely educated. The man flu is no joke. Yeah. Think about your kids. Media gaslighting victims of man flu. It's absolutely disgusting. It's disgusting. The fact that they can sit there, gunshot in the arm, she's got two arms. Absolutely, guys. He gets the man flu, he's done. She's got two arms. She gets shot in one arm. Like, you've got two for a reason. And she literally runs into the ER trying to take a hospital bed up for this man. No excuses. It's absolutely disgusting, man. We need justice. We need justice, and we deserve it. You know what I'm saying? We need to educate the public.
Sorry, I've been man shot in the arm.
Oh my god. See, if she would have come in like that, the doctor needs to be educated. Yo, she absolutely has been man-shot. Okay, see, if she would have come in like that, she never told us she was man-shot. If she would have told us she was man-shot, I don't know. Why wouldn't she say that to open up? It's disgusting. You need to share this with your husband? Your husband has been telling you this for years. You just didn't believe him. He's probably shed light on this so many times, and you gaslighted him. You didn't think he was serious. Man flu is a pandemic. It's an epidemic. It's disgusting the way we're treated. We get man flu and we're expected to just carry on. This lady came in with a gunshot wound. She could have told us in the beginning that it was a man shot. If she would have told us it was a man shot, we would have treated her correctly. Obviously. You bring him soup and video games, you understand his suffering? Absolutely. There's a couple good cures. Some video games, some soup, you need a blanket, a flannel. Sometimes your mom needs to come, like, it's man flu. So this is the article, man flu or immunologically inferior.
Welcome to the first of our Christmas BMJ podcasts. You may have seen in the news today, it's caused consternation on morning TV, and Twitter is aflame with men claiming affirmation for their malingering. Man flu, the phenomenon that men experience the symptoms of a viral illness more than women, is usually met with derision. But a new review, published in the Christmas edition, is asking, is there a plausible biological basis for this sex difference? I'm Duncan Jarvis, multimedia editor for the BMJ.
Wow, guys, if you guys haven't heard this, BMJ is actually shedding some light on man flu. Bro, Dreamboat, thanks for the tier 1 sub. Yo, this man is shedding some light on the man flu. It's absolutely here more on SoundCloud. Let's open this up. He's shedding some light on man flu. I think it's usually absolutely a great idea. Man flu, the phenomenon that men experience the symptoms of viral illness more than women. This is my alarm tone. That's awesome. I listen to this every morning. That's great. You're absolutely a very knowledgeable person. You got to add a hashtag to the title of your stream and spread awareness. Absolutely. We definitely will. We're going to get to that. Kyle Sue is a clinical assistant professor in family medicine at Memorial University in Newfoundland and a GP in Northern Canada and has been looking to research on sex difference to immune response. Wow. Got to support, man. Flu awareness. Absolutely. So this is his article. Okay, let's give this man a chance to talk. You know, I believe that they try to silence us enough. They don't understand our struggle. Absolutely, we need T-shirts, bro. We need hashtags. We need an entire month. We need it to go viral. We need them to understand what is happening with us, and it's absolutely disgusting that they're trying to silence us on mainstream media.
With derision. But a new review, published in the Christmas edition, is asking, is there a plausible biological basis for this sex difference? I'm Duncan Jarvis, multimedia editor for the BMJ. And earlier, I talked to Kyle Sue, a clinical assistant professor in family medicine at the Memorial University of Newfoundland and a GP in Northern Canada. And he's been looking at the research on the sex difference in immune response.
Mm-hmm. He sounds legit. He definitely sounds legit.
If you could just tell us a little bit about yourself. What are you doing up in Canada, up in the north of Canada, and what are you studying?
First of all, he's Canadian. I told you guys, I love Canadians, bro. They're always on point. These guys are absolutely on their P's and Q's. This man, Kyle Sue, is a research professor. He's a clinical assistant of family medicine in Newfoundland, Canada. So the guy absolutely knows what he's talking about. He's trying to shed some light on man flu. And I think that we absolutely should give him a chance to talk. Let's hear what he has to say. They know what they're talking about? Of course they do. He's a man. I know he knows what he's talking about. There's no way he could not. Second of all, besides the fact that he's a man, he's a clinical assistant professor of family medicine. Imagine not believing in science. You know, my wife's watching right now, and I can absolutely tell you right now, guys, that she sometimes doesn't want to believe in the science behind the man flu. I've tried to educate her multiple times. I've tried to explain it to her. She says there's things like you're mansplaining. You're just taking a man's point of view. Some men are sadly unaware. If you could actually believe it, it's absolutely disgusting. You know, and that's what I want to do. I want to educate the men's population. I want to educate women. And hopefully they can take this home to their husbands and let them know. The pain is coming? Yeah, absolutely, man. Erdun, what's up, bro? Let's give this man a chance to talk. He's actually researching man flu.
So I'm a rural general practitioner, and I've been working up in Nunavut territory here in the Canadian Arctic for 5 years now. It covers 2 million square kilometers and three time zones, but there's only 37,000 people spread across this area.
Wow, so this guy is responsible for 37,000 people as practice, over covering three time zones? The sarcasm's so thick, I worry for the new ones. I don't know what sarcasm actually is. Let me actually Google that, because this is all seriousness right now. Sarcasm of man flu. I can't find any. There's actually something on MedExpress too. So we're going to go ahead and check up MedExpress. This was 4 years ago. 4 years ago is when they released an article on this. They don't take it seriously until they get it. Yeah, man, you guys absolutely don't understand what it's like until you get the man flu. I've had it a couple times. Like I said, do men really complain more when they're sick? Do they really act like big babies? This is disgusting. This is absolutely ridiculous. The fact that they would use terminology like this towards us. It's a miracle you're alive? Yeah, like I said, dude, I beat the odds. I've beat the odds multiple times. I've had man flu. There was a time where my wife first experienced me having the man flu. And she wasn't quite knowledgeable. And she didn't understand what was happening to me. Now you can't really blame her. So I don't want you guys to get upset. You can't really blame her. You know what I'm saying? Because she wasn't educated. So we need to shed light on things like this. We need to explain and get this education out there to the masses. The audacity of having to question man flu. I'm sorry, but I'm literally shaking right now. It's okay. Look, please. She wasn't educated. The first time I caught the man flu, all jokes aside, man flu fucked you up. Absolutely, Lokis. And I'm really sorry that you had to deal with that, dude. The fact that you've even lived, you're a hero. Like any man that has had the man flu and can sit here and chat and tell us, you know, the things that are going on, you're a hero. You're a hero. Don't let anybody else tell you that. Don't let your girlfriends tell you that you're not sick. Don't let your wives tell you that you're exaggerating, that it's minor. You guys are heroes. Hearts in chat for anybody with man flu, guys. Hearts in chat for anybody that's gotten man flu.
Okay, son, everything's gonna be fine.
I'm gonna die.
Not if we can help it.
My head's so burning.
How did this happen?
Oh, he caught the cold off me.
Just don't think, do you?
I'm a bit confused. Hasn't he just got a cold?
For God's sake, woman, he's a man. He's got a man cold.
This is absolutely disgusting. Did you not hear her response, boys? Did you not hear her response? I don't understand. He just has a cold. First of all, this is where our awareness and our GoFundMe page will spread awareness. Man flu awareness month. Man flu awareness month, boys. Shameful. It's absolutely disgusting. It's atrocious that a woman can sit here and just say, it's just a cold.
That's right. It's been the butt of jokes for years and years. But finally, the hotly contested issue of whether man flu is real or not has finally been verified. And depending on your sex, you're not going to like the results. According to new research published in the British Medical Journal, the highly contested condition of whether man flu is real or not has now been settled. Canadian researcher Dr. Kyle Sue from Memorial University in St. John's published his findings, in which he states that there is evidence for the manly malady.
My review of all the current literature seems to...
Oh my god! This is Kyle Sue! That's our hero! Guys, hearts in chat for Kyle Sue, bro. The Canadian hero. This is absolutely amazing. We get to see the man in the flesh. We get to hear him. This man took time out of his day. He researched it. He is shedding light on it, and they're trying to silence him. This actually hit the news. This is ridiculous that they have tried to keep this under wraps for so long, boys. 37 times, 37,000 over three time zones. This man is a hero. He is a godsend. He is shedding light. He has researched it.
Suggests that men have weaker immune systems and women have stronger immune systems. So when it comes to common viral respiratory illnesses and the flu, the higher the testosterone level in the blood, the less of an immune response that occurs. So there's higher viral...
The higher amount of testosterone in the system, the lower you are to being able to fight off the man flu.
Levels and fewer immune markers.
The assistant professor's findings go on to verify that men seem to suffer worse than women in cold and flu season, with epidemiological studies suggesting that men were more likely to be
I hope that's a sick joke. I had the woman flu.
Hospitalized and even die than their female counterparts. And despite receiving a few disgruntled emails from the opposite sex, most of Kyle's female friends have been supportive of his work.
You know what? All of my female friends have been laughing at this, and they've been, again, very supportive because they know that I'm not doing this from a misogynistic standpoint, and that, you know, I'm just poking fun at the whole situation, you know, while also presenting important and real research.
Well, if you're still not convinced, don't worry. Most Vancouverites I spoke to are not sure either.
No, not at all. I think it's just... men suffering a little bit extra, just for the fun of it.
Well, I'm not sure, but I do think that men are needier than women.
Absolutely disgusting. What in the fuck is going on here? Just for the fun of it? Needier? This woman is absolutely disgusting. You know, if we were to use things and say like that, that she's not sick, that she's just needy, we'd be ostracized, men. There's just no words for it. This is absolutely
disgusting.
Well, I know
that when I get sick, it's very, very serious. And so, yes, I do think man flu is for real.
A believer. This man is educated. He understands the man flu and its seriousness. You can obviously tell this is a Giga Chad right here. As you can see, the jawline, the beard growth, the full maturity of the beard, the flannel. He's definitely a Chad. This guy's a veteran. Yeah, he is. He's a Chad. He definitely understands the man flu.
So there you have it. Next time your man is collapsed on the couch or dying on death's door, take pity on the poor soul. He may be struck down with man flu. I'm Tom Walsh in Vancouver.